I have some Illustrator preferences that I use when logo designing, but also I'm going to show you a real gem, and that is how to save preference settings in Adobe Illustrator. Making today's video possible is Milanote. Now, I've featured this awesome tool before on my channel, and it is an essential part of my workflow as a designer. You can use Milanote for mapping your projects so that all of the information is in one place, very neat and very concise. It's great for generating and developing ideas throughout the design process, and all of your work can be shared with colleagues and clients at any time. Milanote is in fact free, so click the link in the description below to give it a try today and see how it can allow your designs to evolve and to flourish. The first addition in today's video on Illustrator preferences for logo designing is actually more of a setting. There are various different tools that can actually have more precise modes to them. So for example, I have the pen tool selected right now, and by pressing the caps lock key on your keyboard, I now have a crosshair icon instead of a pen. Now this is useful to me because it's more precise, and the pen icon tends to get in the way. So when I'm designing a logo, I like to see as much of the logo design as possible, and I also like to see exactly where I'm clicking. The caps lock key function doesn't apply to all of the tools, but it does work for quite a lot of them. So experiment by pressing the caps lock key and see what tools you can make more precise. And also remember that later in today's video, I'm going to show you how to save any Illustrator preferences for a specific preset, so stay tuned. Moving on to the second addition in today's list of preferences is your tolerance value. You can see, when I hover the direct selection tool over an anchor point, it automatically is picked up, and watch how long it stays connected as I drag the cursor away. In the preference settings, we can increase this up to a maximum of 8 points, and then see how far away the anchor point will stay linked to the selection tool as I move it away. With this value being this high, you will accidentally select all kinds of things in your workflow, and it's really not ideal, especially for a logo design. So I'm going to advise you to lower this value down to 1, which is the lowest setting possible for this preference. And now you're not going to accidentally select objects that you don't want to select. The next preference that I'd like to use for logo designing is the zoom to object function. By default, if I zoom in with the keyboard shortcut, it zooms into the center of the screen. This can be useful, but when I'm designing a logo, I like to activate the zoom to selection option. This saves time, and in my opinion, it just makes life easier as a logo designer. If I'm working on a specific part of a logo and I want to zoom into it, I can automatically do that without hesitation or hassle. Now I've got two more main preference settings for logo designing before I show you how to save all of your preferences as one preset. If I group together this design here with a keyboard shortcut, I can still move and edit individual objects as I wish. Now how do I do that? I double click the design and enter into the isolation mode, which is another essential preference that I use. You can use a direct selection tool as well, but this is more efficient in my opinion. In the preference settings menu, you can find the setting here, and it's often turned on by default. But also in this menu is the increments value, and this is how far you can nudge an object by pressing the left and the right key on your keyboard. And this setting needs to be changed over time, depending on the design and the size of the artboard. And the last preference setting today, before the awesome tip at the end of the video, is the scaling options. This design has a stroke around it, and if I duplicate it by holding down the Alt Option key, and then make it smaller, the stroke actually scales down proportional to the design. Now this is handy when resizing objects, and I rarely switch the setting off when I'm designing a logo. But sometimes I do, so it is handy to know where it is. If I do go into the preference settings and switch it off, you will notice what happens when I resize the logo. The stroke stays the same size in numerical values, but not in relation to the scale of the design. So yeah, there were some preferences on designing a logo. How can we save them specifically for logo design, so that when we enter into a logo project, our settings are ready for us to use? So as a quick example, let's drag out the appearance panel and also the Pathfinder window, two things that I use very often in logo designs. And just to prove that we can save preference settings, I will change this value here to 0.25 to test later in the video. So just remember it's 0.25. When you have the preferences you wish, go into Edit, Settings, and then Export. Simply type in the setting name, so my settings are in place for logo designing, and then select a file location to save it. Now that the settings are saved, and to conclude the test, I'm going to change the setting from 0.25 to 1 and then click OK. And if I go back and check, it is still set to 1. Now if I want to load the settings that I just saved, we need to go back to Edit, Settings, and then Import. Find the file and then click OK, and Illustrator is going to have to restart, so make sure to save all of your projects. So once Illustrator is rebooted, create a new document, and then you're going to notice that once my document has been created, I have the appearance panel and the Pathfinder panel ready for me, which I saved earlier. And as I said, the setting that I saved of 0.25 has in fact been saved, as are all of the other preference settings. Now that is how you can save your settings in Illustrator. I did make a video with preference settings before, so today I chose some different ones to go over and show you something new. Thanks again to Milanote for sponsoring today's video. And you can try out their product for planning your next creative project by clicking the link in the description below. Also, remember to subscribe to my channel if you want to expand your skills as a graphic designer. Like and share my content on social media, and of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.